This tutorial is going to take you through the very basics of working with After Effects. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to look at creating a new project and then navigating the interface. And that means we're going to look at all of the different pieces of the interface that are standard in the standard workflow and what they mean. Then we're going to look at creating and using type, and we're going to look at animation basics. And that would be using the timeline, looking at things like opacity, scale, position, rotation, although we aren't going to do all of those. And then we're going to look at little commands like maximize a selected window and show keyframes and other kinds of hotkeys that will make the process a lot easier for you. So when we first start After Effects, this is pretty much what we've got. Now notice that this is After Effects CS6, which is a little different from the Creative Cloud series, which is constantly changing. But this basically tells you some idea of what we're working with. I normally don't work with this. You can open a project or create a new composition or open a recent one, but I would suggest actually going through and clicking close and starting it from scratch, which means going up to File and doing Open Project, Open Recent Projects, or to make a new project. So in this case, I already have an untitled project open, so I don't need to make a new project, but I'll go ahead and do that anyway, so you can see you have this project and it looks like this. And then you can go through and make a composition. So I'm going to go to Composition and New Composition. So here you can see I've got HDTV 1080, which is HD, 1920 by 1080 pixels, at 29.97, or basically 30 frames per second. Square pixels, full resolution, although let's make this half. We can change this as we choose to, but basically this means that you can see or preview the project at full resolution or less if it's taking up too much power. This is 30 seconds here, and the background color is black, although it doesn't really matter. You can always make that different later. I can change this composition to sample for class or something, right? So I can always rename that as well by going to my composition, right-clicking, and going to rename. Or actually, it's not gonna let me do that. It's up here in the project file. So here's where you can go to composition settings and you can change the name. Okay, so from here, I just wanna show you a little bit about the things that we've got in this. Now, this is a standard workspace. You go into Window, Workspace, this is standard. You can also choose this and then reset it so that it looks exactly like this. And I wanna point out that there are some windows missing here. So I can always bring those back. So let's say I want to bring my character window back. Here I've got my character window. I might want to bring back my effects and or my effect controls, which is up here. And this would allow you to alter any effects that you've got in here. But the basic ones are project, where you've got all of the files that you're going to use will be in here, and you import them here. You can actually double click. And then it will allow you to import a file from your desktop or from wherever you want. You've got your the preview of the composition, which is in here. And notice that you can actually open multiple compositions. We'll see that later, or multiple layers. Often if something isn't working in your animation, it's because you've opened the layer and not the composition. So always check this if something isn't working. You've got where you are in the composition. You can see the X and Y is changing up there as I move my mouse. You've got your audio controls, preview controls, we have auto resolution here it's at half because it's auto. We can change it to full, half, one third, whatever. Auto just basically does how fast your computer is to how complex your animation is. You have effects and presets, and you've got your character, and then of course you've got your composition, and this is called the timeline. Notice this goes from 0 seconds all the way to 30 seconds because that's what we chose our composition to be, and of course that can be changed as you go. So we're not going to do anything really complex with this right now. The first thing we're going to do is just mess with some type. So the first thing I do here is click on my type tool. You can notice that all the tools are up here. And I'm going to go ahead and just click in. I notice I've got, right now it's set to nothing for the fill, which is the inside of the type, and then I've got white on the outside. So if I type, it's going to look like this. Over there, notice it goes off the screen. If I press, hold down Control, it changes it to the select, which is this button basically. but it's easier to just press Control. So I'm going to click in here, press Control, and then I can move it around. And then let's say I want to change this out. Let's say I want to make a new one. So I'm going to deselect, click out here, then I'm going to click down in here. My name is Ted. Okay, so I'm going to press Control again, then I want to move it, let's say, over here. Actually, I'm going to go ahead and move all of these around a little bit. Notice that I have to deselect to remove it from this one to begin to pull in this one. Okay, so that doesn't look great, obviously, right? But it could be worse. So let's say I want to mess with this a little bit. My name is Ted is here. Let's say I want to actually make this white or a different color. So I'm going to click on my fill, and let's say I want to make this red. Maybe not quite such a horrendous red. And notice that here I've got a white outline, the stroke, and then a red fill. So here there isn't actually black in the middle. That's actually just transparent. There's nothing in the middle there at all. So I'm going to remove the stroke because I think that looks horrible. So I'm going to click on the stroke, and then I'm going to say no stroke color at all. But notice what's happening here is I haven't actually selected any of the text. So I'm going to highlight all of that and then do the same thing. And there we go. It disappears. Okay, so that's the basics of type. And you'll notice here that these both appear. There's this red line for the entire 30 seconds of the screen. I'm going to zoom out a little bit so you can see it. And this is the zoom. This is really close up. This is really far away. So 30 seconds. That seems really big to me. So I'm going to highlight both of these just by clicking and dragging in here. You can see they're both highlighted. I can also press click and then Control and click the other one. And then I'm going to grab the end here and make it shorter. I think maybe 4 seconds is more than long enough to have these up. So now when I go, if I press spacebar to preview it, you can move along and you can see after 4 seconds it disappears. But that doesn't really make any sense, right? I want it to say hello there first and then my name is Ted. So I'm going to click on the My Name is Ted thing and I'm going to drag this over. So I'm going to have it start about halfway or about, three quarters of the way through. And now for 3 seconds, hello there, and then my name is Ted pops up. And then you'll notice that hello there disappears. It still looks pretty clumsy though, and that's when you start to worry about animation. So we're going to play with a couple of different kinds of animation. And you'll notice that if you click on this little drop-down menu, you can see text and transform. It's transform that we want to worry about, not animate in this case. So you've got a couple of options. You've got your anchor point, which when you click in here, the anchor point is this little dot here that's looks like a target. And all animations are going to happen around the anchor point. And so you might need to move that at some point. And you move it with this tool up here, which is called the pan behind tool. Okay, but for transform, we have anchor point, we have position, so where it is on the screen, scale, how big or small it is, rotation, is it to the side, is it up and down, whatever. And then we have opacity, which is 100%. So opacity is how dark it is. Basically, is it transparent or is it not transparent? So at this point, what I want to do is actually change my opacity. But I don't want all of this stuff open. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight both of these. So Control, so both of these are there. And I'm going to press T. And T is opacity. So I'm going to click out. And then I'm going to click on this little stopwatch icon. And it's going to give me what's called a keyframe. And that basically means at 0 seconds, it is at this value, 100% opacity. Okay. Now I actually don't want it to be 100% opacity, I want it to be invisible. So I'm going to click here and change it to 0. So this is transparent. Now I'm going to move in maybe a half a second, and I'm going to click back in here and press 100. So you'll notice it appears again. So here it's at 0%, here it's at 100%. If I preview it by pressing spacebar again, you'll see that it actually fades in. Very, very simple animation. So at this point, like later in, what I want this to be is at 100 again. So I want to stop here at 100. So I'm going to click this little button to add a keyframe. And then I'm going to move forward a little. And I'm going to change this to 0. Now, the reason why I didn't have to click this button again is that when you change to a point in time when there's no keyframe, you change the value, it automatically makes a keyframe. At this point, though, right here, So if I want to move over there, I can click this little button here to move over to this. At this point, this is at 100, and it was already at 100 because this is at 100 as well. So at this point, I can simply add a keyframe in, and it keeps it at the same value. So what's going to happen here is it's going to start at 0, it's going to fade into 100, it's going to stay at 100, and here's where it's going to start fading out. And let's say I want to do the same thing here. I want this for My Name is Ted. I'm going to select it. I'm going to make this 0 opacity. Notice that no keyframe appeared. Why? Because I didn't animate. So I'm going to click on animation. Now 0%, great. Move forward a little bit. And I want to change it to 100. Now what's going to happen is it's going to have a keyframe here. I'm going to move forward, add a keyframe, and then I'm going to bring it down to 0. And notice that this one's a little closer than these. You can actually stretch this out just by moving the toggle switch. So here, you can see it fades in pretty quickly. But if I move it out to here, it's going to actually fade in really slowly. And so you can get some really nice effects by just playing with the spacing of your keyframes. Okay, so this actually is going to look pretty decent. Hello there, okay. My Name is Ted fades in, then Hello There fades out, and then My Name is Ted fades out. So some pretty basic stuff, but doesn't look too bad. All right, so now I think we're done with opacity. So I'm gonna highlight both of these again, and I can press T to remove opacity, or you can just press P and it will just switch to position. And here's where it gets really fun. We can actually move this around and choose where we want it to be. So at this point, we want it to be here, right? And in fact, we probably want to stay until it actually appears here. So let's animate. So we know here, at this point in time, we want it to be in this place. But let's say I want it to move to the side now. So, well, let's say it's going to appear there. Maybe let's, and of course I've highlighted both of these again, so I want to delete this out. Now this guy is fine. So at this point in time, I want it to be here, and let's go ahead and put another keyframe here just so we know. It starts here, it stays here. Okay, so at this point, I want it to start moving. So if I move into this place in time, and again, I can hold down control to get this this other piece, or I can click here for the selection tool, or press V. I can just drag to the side, and notice how I can make it move here, which is fine, right? And what it will do is this. And that looks okay, but it's a little clunky. So instead, what I'm gonna do is move this around. And I can actually just shift my x-axis and y-axis. So y, of course, is how far up and down it is. X is side to side. So I can just click and drag. So I want it to be there. Notice that the y is staying the same, in other words. Only the x is changing. Okay, so that's here. Okay, great. So now I want to start moving it up. So I want it to move to the side and then up. So what I have to do here is add in another keyframe to keep it at this spot. So at this spot, it's still here. So it moves over, it stays here. And now at this point, I want it to start moving. So let's say I want it to be up here. So here, I can simply do the same thing. Control and move it up. And so again, of course, you could just do it here with leave your x-axis alone and just change your y-axis. But this looks exactly like I want it to look, right? Now you'll notice that because I made this a hold keyframe, these are also hold keyframes, and that's not what I want. So I can actually hold down control and click here to change it to a regular one. And I'll do the same for this. So what's happening is that it moves over, holds it, and then moves up. Okay? So pretty simple. Okay. Just moves. And then My Name is Ted comes in. And then let's do something a little bit more interesting with this. Let's actually rotate this around and then have it maybe fly off the screen or something. So let's say at this point it's where we want it to be. Okay, so I'm gonna do position here. So this is good. And then let's say we want to rotate this. So I'm going to just open up everything here instead of just position. So I've got rotation. So I'm going to animate rotation as well so it stays here. And then I'm going to actually rotate this 90 degrees. And I'm going to do that a little bit further in. So 90 degrees. That's not really the way I wanted it to go. So let's do negative 90 degrees. There we go. My name is Ted. Now that looks fine, except it's not really where I wanted it to be. I wanted it to be in a different spot. I wanted it to be to rotate maybe not in this around the center point, which is what it's doing now, but around the edge. So the way to do that is to simply change the anchor point. And I can do that anywhere here because the anchor point isn't animated. So I'm going to grab my pan behind tool, and I'm going to move the anchor point over. So I want it to be on this bottom edge here. Okay, so now when I rotate, it'll rotate along this side. So you can see that. Now, I have no idea. It seems to actually have animated the anchor point here, which again is really strange. So let's just back up. Okay. So at this point, let's just go ahead and move the anchor point. You can see that that's just because I'm not messing with anything with position. It just allows me to go ahead and move the anchor point. So now here, throughout the whole thing, the anchor point's on the corner. And this is, of course, why you should think these things through before you start messing with it, just because it allows you to have a little bit more control as you go. So at this point, then again, I'm at this this position point. My scale is here, my rotation is here, so I'm going to move in, and then I'm going to rotate this at negative 90. Okay, so that's better. Except, you know, it's still a little weird because now my name is off the screen. So I also want to move position. So I'm going to move my y-axis down. Now maybe you want to do that at the beginning, right? So maybe you want to, or you want to do it at the same time, however you want to go. So if I do it at the same time, I can go ahead and I can just move my position down. Right, and maybe I want to move it all at the same time to a different place or whatever, but now what it looks like is it's going to move over like that. So that looks pretty cool. And then let's pause a little bit. So let's add in a position anchor point. And then I'll move forward a little bit. And let's move it on the x-axis over. And then let's pause a little bit more, just for fun. And then let's throw it off the screen. So let's go here. And let's move it completely off on the y-axis. You can see it gives you that bounding box even though it's invisible. So what it's gonna look like now is, hello there. Moves, right? Fades in, rotates, moves, and fades out, right? So this actually looks really, really complicated, but it's actually not. It's all just a bunch of really simple things, right? So in this one, we start at nothing. We fade in here. Now we move. Well, actually, this is position, so hold on one second. I'm going to highlight both of these. You can press Control to highlight them both. And then I'm going to press U. And U gives me all of the active keyframes, so it allows you to just kind of condense down a little bit. Okay, so here, we've faded in, and we're still at this normal position. Faded in at the position. Now I'm going to move and hold. Now I'm going to move again. And you can notice at this point, my name is Ted is going to animate in right here. And I'm there. Now I'm going to start fading out here. And now here's where my position and rotation come in. So I'm going to move, rotate. Now it's going to pause. Now it's going to move right here. It moves. And you can see the values changing on this side. Then it pauses. Then it moves some more. And at the same time, it's going to start animating out. The final thing that's important to know is how to actually save the file and to export the file to be able to go up to YouTube. So really, you just go to File and then Save As. And it's going to bring you the same piece here. And I'm gonna go to where I normally go, to my tutorials, and I'm gonna call this, let's say, AE Practicum 1 video. Although it doesn't really matter, right? So let's just say I'll call it AE Practicum because I'm gonna use this throughout. Notice this is the project file. So I'm gonna click on save. And what this is going to do is it's actually gonna create a little folder and it's gonna create an After Effects file. And I'll show you what that looks like. So here you can see I've got my file folders, tutorials. And you can see here I've got my aepracticum.aep file, right? Okay, so this is a very useful folder, but you can see, oh, actually I did not create a file folder. I would probably have to make one. So I can create a folder that's called like After Effects Project or something and keep everything in there. And that's very important to have everything in one folder. So right now I'm just gonna call this After Effects project files, and you're going to keep everything together in this one file folder, including your AE Practicum file. Now, of course, I have to close this out to be able to move it, and I don't want to do that yet, so just take my word for it. So from here, we want to be able to export this. So I'm going to click on my composition. This is very important. You have to have clicked on the composition. And you'll notice that we're also really, this is really long, so what's going to happen here is I'm going to have 7 seconds of stuff and then another 27 or 23 seconds of nothing, which is okay in this case. It doesn't really matter, just the practicum. But if you want to make it shorter just to show me that you can do this, that's fine. And I want to go to composition, and I want to go to add to render queue. And what this is going to do is it's going to send it to a program to actually start compiling this as a video. And there's a bunch of options here, and you can click to where you want it to output. So right now it's in a weird place. I'm going to put it in my on my desktop, sample for class. Okay. And I can choose my settings here. So lossless, best settings, whatever, you know. There's a bunch of different options that you can use. But in the output, AVI is fine, you know, RGB is fine, none of this really matters. You can choose whether or not you want to output audio, in many cases you will. You can crop it, you can resize it, etc., which I wouldn't really recommend doing. Just leave it alone here. And then you want to be able to go to render settings and make sure that you can choose full resolution, best quality. And this should be about right. Nothing else really needs to be changed. So when this is done, you go ahead and you click on render, and this is what's actually going to produce your file. And so when you actually go to your whatever file folder you've set this to export to, you're going to find the AVI file or whatever kind of file you've been exporting. And that is what you go through and upload to YouTube. Hope this has been helpful.